Happy morning, students. How you all? Yeah, I hope you all are well. Okay. After term one exam, you have a leave, and today is the first session for term two. Yes, no? Yes, dears. Today we going to start the term two with our civics. Okay. Already we completed two chapters in civics. Okay, first chapter equality in Indian democracy, and second chapter our government in health department. Yes, no? Our government in health. Yes, no? That is we completed already the role of the government in health. Okay, that we completed. Equality in Indian democracy is a lot of inequality present in our country, and also what are the steps taken by the government to bring the equal among the people. Okay, example that midday meal, everything. Okay, in the second lesson, the role of the government in the health department. Okay, so in India, the health department was divided into two sectors, that is private sector and public sector. Okay, people prefer the private sector because the correct time, treatment and cleanliness. Okay, so because of that, they ready to spend more huge money for their treatment. But in same time, that is not applicable for all the people. Okay, so huge amount, lot of people depends the government hospitals. That is not a single sectors, it is a chain. Okay, so primary health centers in cities and in the district specialized hospitals, everything. Okay, that we discussed in the last two chapters. So today the third chapter for you, what? Yes, what is the third chapter for you? The state government. Okay, how the state government function, that is the third chapter for you. Okay, yes, how the state government works. Okay, yes, already we know that India is one nation that is divided into 29 states for administration purpose. Each state has its own government, separate government, and its own chief minister. How it is run, and what are the works done by the state governments or their state people? Who are the members in the, who are making the state government? What are the role of the government? Government, everything we will see in this lesson. Okay. Yes. First. Yes. State legislature in India. These are the general things you want to know, so you kindly listen. State legislature in India, legislative council, legislative assembly, state functionaries, role of political parties, people's power, role of media. These things you are going to learn in this lesson. Not learn, you going to know. Okay, because civics is not a subject for learning. Okay, because history, that is not, we learn about the past. Geography, that also we learn about our surroundings and also our job. But civics is a practical life, so you want to know what's going around. Okay, that's only the civics. So you're going to know these things from this lesson. What are the state legislature in India, legislative council, legislative assembly, state functionaries, role of political parties, people's power, role of media. Okay, yes, yes. Now take your civics book, all of you. Page number, third lesson. What is the page number, Chalapatis? Yes, page number 30. Take care. Very good. formed at the state level and its functions. Okay. Yes. Whose responsibility? Okay. See your book, all of you. Yes. Page number 30. Hey, look at this. It says that there is a water shortage in our state and people are falling sick due to the water shortage and people also falling sick. In many villages, people were found to be drinking unclean water. Streams, unclean water, that is stream have dried up and so have tanks. In the worst affected areas, villages have been carrying water across great distances. The second strike explains that water scarcity and also how people fall ill. Okay. Then again, people of the district HQ, that means headquarters, Patalpuram, receive water supply once in 3 days. Okay, Patalpuram or Patalpuram. Once in 3 days, they receive the water supply. The district hospital here is overflowing with patients. Okay, another problem is what? The district office head hospital overflowing with the number of patients. A large number of women are children with acute diarrhea. So, lot of children affected by diarrhea. Diarrhea is a communicable disease or waterborne diseases. We already know that. Okay. On the TV news, they say 10 people have died from diarrhea. Is that possible? Can one really die from it? Yes, she asked him. Is it possible due to diarrhea if anyone able to die? Who knows? Just hope. I don't get it. Simply he said, she said, I don't know because I didn't get any diarrhea. Then, that afternoon, my mother said not to have any iced drinks from the market. She gave one of her lecturers this morning. You have to be responsible for your health. Shirin. Okay, her name is Shirin. Also, his mother saying you should not drink any ice, that is cool drinks or sarbat or any other juice, should not drink from the market sites. Why her mother is saying like that? Because she think that they will not prepare that drinks in good water. Okay, that means good drinking water. That's why she informed in that way. Now, this road is blocked due to the rally. They have gathered the MLA's residents. Rally, really? Why has her done something? Haha. They seem more angry about what he has not done. Okay, so all the people in that Patalpuram gathered a rally to showing they are against and showing they are angry against their MLA. Because MLA want to take care of these necessary things. So they are make a rally. And we demand, that means that person, and we demand that the authorities take immediate action to bring the public health situation under control. Our MLA must take the responsibility for this. In that crowd, an aged person shouting and he is saying, we demand the authorized person. Who is the authorized person here? That MLA. Okay? So, he asked him to that MLA that he want to bring the control and make everything normal. Okay. What a loud voice he has. He must be a leader or something. I saw him on TV too. He is a member of the opposition. Opposition means what, Kanan? Yes, opposition means if a ruling party then the party which not winning the election, they are called opposition. Okay, see, for example, in our Tamil Nadu, now who ruling our state? AIADMK. Okay, Mr. Edappadi Palanichami is our honorable chief minister. Okay, this person was elected by us. Okay, AIADMK. They ruling our state. Okay, then who is the opposition? DMK party is the opposition party. Okay, yes. So like this, here also they are conveying in that way. Okay. There are three levels of government. What are the three levels? Already we discussed these things from our grade 3 itself. Okay, national union, that is one country level that covers the whole country. Then state covers the entire state. Then local governs towns and villages. Simply, okay, local government, state government and central government. The central government rule over the country. Okay, now why is there need for three levels of government? Why do we do have three levels of government? Why one level is not enough for us? Central government alone is enough, no? Because all the whole country is under the control of central government. So it is not enough. Why we need three levels? India is a vast country, okay? India is a vast country with many diversities. The problems and aspiration of people in villages and small towns are different from those living in cities, okay? Children, do you understand why we need three levels of government? India, first reason, India is a vast country, okay? And second, people have different problems. If a village people, they have their own problem. It is not like the people, it is not like the problem which town people have. Okay. The government meets the needs and demands of people by dividing itself into three levels. This is called decentralization of power. That means distribution of power in their categories. Wherein each level has its own area of functioning. Okay. Yes, now take your book, all of you. Page number 31. Wait, functions of government, we will see. See the book, page number 31. In the above section, you have read about some events in Patalpuram. You may be familiar with some officials' names, such as collector, medical officer, etc. But have you heard of an MLA? What is the abbreviation for MLA? Yes, member of legislative assembly. Do you know the MLA of your area? You want to give the answer to me. You write. Okay, what is MLA? MLA. Then who is our area MLA and your area MLA also? Because our school, you people are in different areas, are coming from different areas. So you give your own MLA's name. Can you identify which party she or he belongs to? Okay, that is an important question. Give the answer to me. Then members of legislative assembly are called MLA. They elected by the people, they then become members of legislative assembly and also from the government. That you can listen. See the blue color question, all of you. What is happening in Patalpuram? Patalpuram, due to heavy water scarcity, people fall ill, their hospital overflow with the patients. Okay, why is this problem serious? Because the MLA will not consider and give and not take necessary steps. Then what action do you think can be taken in the above situation, and who do you think should take care of this action? Okay, so you give the answer to me later. Okay, send me the voice message. Okay, dear, for these three questions you give the answer to your voice, to my WhatsApp voice message. Okay, now you listen. Functions of government. First, how they make the government, we know. Every 5 years, on the day of election, the people cast their vote and select their representatives. National government, here, what are the functions of the three levels government? National government makes decision on matters that concern the entire country, like defense, issue of currency, foreign affairs, etc. State government makes decision on issues related to the state, like agricultural policy of the state. Local government is responsible for managing the affairs of small towns and villages. Then composition of the legislative assembly. How they participate in the legislative council? Yes, take page number 32, all of you. In this way, we say that the MLAs represent people. The example below will help us understand this better. Every state in India has legislative assembly. Each state is divided into different areas or constituencies. Okay, each state was divided into areas, that is called constituency, parliamentary areas, or taluks in that way. For example, look at the map below. Okay, they given Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, Uttarakhand. 68, Himachal Pradesh is divided into 68 assembly constituencies. Question for you, how many constituencies are there in Tamil Nadu? From each constituency, the people elect one representative who then become a member of the legislative assembly. You would have noticed that people stand for election in the name for different parties. These MLAs therefore belong to the different political parties. Okay children? Yes. The question is two questions. That three questions. Added one more question, that how many constituencies are in our Tamil Nadu. Okay? Yes. The Legislative Council is a partly nominated and partly elected body. Okay, Legislative Assembly is separate. Legislative Council. This is Legislative Council. Okay, here nominated party and elected also party. Nearly 5/6 of the member Legislative Council are elected and the remaining 1/6 is nominated. Okay, dear children, please you wait. We will continue in the next 15 minutes. Okay, please you wait.